And now for the thrilling adventures of Lightning Jim. It was a dark, moonless night on the plains as two masked riders rode past along a lonely trail.
Now, this is the trail, Snag.
Yeah. I reckon we ought to be showing up pretty soon, too, Shorty.
Yeah, we're due to leave the last station about an hour ago.
Yeah.
Hold on. Here he comes now.
Yeah, he's sure traveling fast.
We'll keep back of these rocks. He won't be seeing us till he gets on top of us.
He's carrying a rifle, too.
Well, he won't get a chance to use it.
Ah, hold up there.
There he is.
All right, let him have it.
Oh, Thunder, oh boy. Dizzy, Thunder.
There's the talk, buddy.
You're like just the poor eagle laying on the ground.
This is bad, buddy.
Is he dead?
Yeah. Bullet right through his head.
Oh, and he is just a young fella, too.
Yeah. This was the shooting we heard coming down the trail.
He like him in the bag that was laying on the ground.
Let me look at it.
No.
Buddy, this is a mail pouch.
A mail pouch?
Yeah, this young Jasper's a Pony Express rider.
You believe me?
Back in 1860, the United States government established the famous Pony Express to carry mail swiftly on horseback from St. Joseph, Missouri, over the plains and mountains to the Pacific coast. That was before the railroads and telegraph lines spanned the great American plains. The impending crisis of the Civil War made swift communication between the older states and California a necessity. The Pony Express service was maintained for only 16 months before it was supplanted by a telegraph line. The animals used were, of course, not ponies, but fleet American horses. United States Marshal Lightning Jim Whipple and his deputy Whitey Larson were on the trail of outlaws when they heard shots down the trail. They spurred on their horses and found a young Pony Express rider who had been shot and killed. They picked up the body and started for the nearest town.
Well, Lightning, we come out here to find some bandits, and by the looks of things, I don't think they are wary for these.
Yeah, we got our work cut out for us, all right. Killing a Pony Express rider is bad business.
Sure, I suppose they need us for theft of money.
I reckon so. Anyhow, they cleaned out the mail pouch.
Sure, a young fella's rifle was fired off, so he must have put up a fight.
Yeah, he was carrying out his orders to protect the mail.
Well, I tell you, these Pony Express riders, they don't get much protection.
That's right, buddy. They travel fast and take their chances on outrunning the road agents and hostile Indians. How'd you like to be a Pony Express rider, Whitey?
Well, I think there will be lots of excitement. But I tell you, though, I really think you're being a deputy marshal instead of a gunner.
All right, Deputy Larson, look up ahead there.
So, you're coming into some town?
Yeah, who's on the steady boy?
You see what you're stopping for?
Whitey, we ain't been out in this section before.
Sure, that's so.
So you better let me do the talking.
Sure, sure.
Bringing in this dead rider is going to cause some excitement. You don't know what we'll have to run into.
Sure. Sir, what's he driving at, Lightning?
Take off your badge and put it in your pocket.
No more suspects.
You heard me. I'm doing the same thing.
Oh, I get it. You don't want them to know that you are a marshal, huh?
Yeah. Leastways, not right away until we get the lay of the land. Remember, my name will be Jennings.
You're Mr. Jennings.
And your name is Swenson.
You're Sven Swenson. But say, you know something?
No, what?
I bet that you forget when you call me right.
I just take that bet. How about a steak dinner?
By golly, now you're talking my language.
All right, but remember, if you forget and call me Lightning, I get the steak dinner from you.
All right, Mr. Yenny.
Let's go, Thunder.
There's his horse, Cody.
Well, come in, boy. I've been waiting for you.
Howdy, Colonel.
Hiya. Did you meet the express rider?
Yeah, we met him all right, and here's what we got.
Ah, the letter. Good.
We had a hard time.
Well, sit down, boy. Sit down. Let's see. St. Joseph, William Center, Abilene.
Here's one. Is there cash in that one?
What?
I said, is there cash in that one?
No, it's from Washington. Too bad.
Oh, what's the trouble, Colonel?
Yeah, it's not the one I was expecting. But it'll do.
You mean there ain't no cash in any of them letters?
I'm not after cash.
Well, what's the good of robbing these express riders?
Yeah. We get hard money when we hold up the stage coaches.
I'm paying you men good money to get this mail. What I want it for is none of your business. You understand?
Oh, sure. No need to get head up, Colonel. As long as you keep paying the price, we'll get the mail for you.
Yeah. Well, it's going to cost him off. We got to drill another rider.
What? Did you all kill that rider?
Well, sure, he wouldn't stop. Took a shot at us with his rifle.
Well, we drilled him. Any objections?
You fools. When they find that rider, they'll be getting up a posse to cover the whole country.
Well, that don't scare us, Colonel. We've had posses out there before.
Sure. And besides, there ain't nothing for you to worry about, Colonel. Ever since you come out here, you've been staying at Sam Porter's ranch. And he's the sheriff, ain't he?
Yes, I know all that. Robbing the riders is one thing, but robbing and killing an express rider is likely to interfere with my plans. Did you leave his body on the trail?
Sure. You didn't expect us to bring it back here, did you?
No. But if you all left tracks, they can trail you up here.
Nah. We took the long trail over the ridge and doubled back. And we'll be following our trail.
Hey, listen, Colonel. You talk like we don't know nothing. You take care of your side of the business. We'll be taking care of ours.
Are you telling me what to do?
Yeah.
Why, you...
Stop it! Put that gun back, Colonel. Same goes for you, Snag. One move and I'll let you both have it.
Oh, now. Well,
what's so funny?
Oh, I'm powerful sorry, Snag. I reckon I got a little two-sided and lost my temper.
Yeah. Tempers ain't healthy in this country, Colonel. How about the rest of the cash we got coming for this job?
Yeah, I was just coming to that. Now, here's for tonight's work and a little advance on the next job.
All right, Colonel. When's the next job coming up?
I'm going back to Midville now before the sheriff gets suspicious of my being away. I want to be there when they find that rider.
Yeah, but what about us?
There's another rider due to come through Midville tonight. And I think he'll be carrying the message I've been waiting for.
Oh. So you want me and Snag to take another mail pouch?
Yes, that's right, Jordy. I'll go back to town and meet one of you in the cafe tonight. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Then until tonight, good day, gentlemen.
Good day, rat.
Now, what's the matter with you, Snag?
He smells bad to me. Wouldn't cuss him nohow.
Well, he pays good.
Wonder what he's looking for in that mail.
I don't know. Seems funny, all right, except he ain't looking for cash.
Yeah, he's got the cash, and if we're smart, we'll get it. All.
Well, it looks like the stage station where the rider's being caught us.
Yeah. Hey, here comes the fella now.
Howdy, mister.
Is this the Pony Express stage?
Sure is. What can I do for you?
Come over here. I want to show you something.
Sure.
I found this young chap out on the trail a little while ago. Know him?
Holy smoke. He's killed.
Yeah. Me and my partner found him on the trail and tied him to his horse and brought him in. Figured you'd know who he is.
Gosh, Fred Fisher.
Fred Fisher, huh? Where'd he live?
Willow.
Were you trying to say Willow Banks?
Just get the job, please.
Oh, that's too bad.
Here comes Sam Porter. Sam. Yeah.
Oh, Sam.
Sam. Hurry up, quick.
What's the trouble, Cale?
Fred, he's killed.
What?
Sure, look.
Suffering snake. Drilled through the head.
Oh, this is awful.
What's all excitement, Sheriff?
Look for yourself, Colonel.
Good Lord. When did this happen?
Oh, about an hour ago, I'd say.
Bring him in, Sheriff.
No. Who are you, mister?
Sheriff, my name is Jennings, and this is my partner, Swenson.
Oh, that's me, Swenson.
Where'd you find him?
On the trail west of town. Me and my partner heard some shots, and when we got to the spot, we found this young chap on the ground.
Did you all see anyone else?
No. We haven't done the shooting, made a fast getaway.
Did you try to follow him?
No, Sheriff. Naturally, we figured we ought to bring in the body and turn it over to you.
Hey, there's a mail pouch on the horse.
Yeah, but it's empty now.
It's cleaned out.
Stranger, where'd you gents come from?
Well, we've been up in Nebraska. We're heading down to Kansas. Hunt cattle, sir.
What are you going to do, Sheriff?
Now, what do you suppose? I'm going after the critters that done this killing. I'm getting up a posse right now.
We'll be glad to help you, Sheriff.
Mister. I ain't saying you and your partner had anything to do with this killing, but you're strangers around here, and I gotta be sure you stay till we get this business cleared up.
Sure, we'll stay, Sheriff.
Well, I ain't taking chances. One of you's coming with a posse, and t'other is going to the jail.
I see. All right, Sheriff. I'll go with you, and my partner will wait in jail. That suits you, Swenson?
Oh, you're like Mr. Yen.
Sheriff, right there for them rocks.
Well, I'm going to have a look.
I hear some flash, Sheriff.
They
could have went south.
Gentlemen, my name is Banks, Colonel Banks, sir.
I'm glad to know you, Colonel.
You and your partner are looking for jobs.
Reckon so, Colonel. Man's got to live, you know.
Of course, yes, sir. That's a mighty handsome piece of horse flesh you got there, sir.
Yeah.
Would you sell him?
I reckon not, Colonel. But you were speaking about a job.
All right, boys, let's get moving.
Oh, I'll talk to you later, Jennings, and think over what I said about that horse you got.
I'll give you a good price.
Come on, Colonel. And you too, Jennings.
Come on, boy.
Will Lightning, Jim, and Whitey capture the men who killed the Pony Express rider? Who is Colonel Banks? And what about the sheriff and Cal Drake? Are they mixed up in this plot to rob the mails? The answers to these questions will come in part two of this thrilling story, which follows immediately. Now for part two of the thrilling adventures of Lightning Jim in the Pony Express. United States Marshal Lightning Jim Whipple and his deputy Whitey Larson found the bullet-riddled body of a Pony Express rider. The murderers had robbed the mail pouch and left the rider's body on the trail near the town of Midville. Lightning Jim and Whitey took the body to the sheriff. They met Colonel Banks and the stage tender, Cal Drake. The marshal and his deputy decided to go under the assumed names of Jennings and Swenson. But since they were strangers in town, the sheriff insisted that Whitey stay in jail while Jim went out with a posse to find the murderers. When the posse got back to town...
That's all for now, boys.
Now, call you again if I need you.
Well, Sheriff, I reckon I'll be going back to your ranch.
All right, Colonel. And Jennings, you come along with me.
Sure. I reckon you can let my partner go now.
Not so fast, mister. I ain't through with this business by a long shot. Just because we didn't find them critters ain't no reason to give up.
That's right.
So I reckon you better join up with your partner in the jail for a few days more.
But, Sheriff, you don't think Jennings and his partner had anything to do with the killing, do you?
Well, I ain't saying yes, and I ain't saying no. If they're innocent, they hadn't ought to mind seeing a spell with free room and board.
Sheriff's right, Colonel. I'm willing to do anything to help catch the Jaspers that done the killing. Let's go, Sheriff.
Sure. All right, see you later, Colonel.
Yes.
Now, take care of your horse, Jennings.
Hey, wait a second, Colonel.
What's the trouble, Cal?
Did you find him? The fellow that killed Fred?
No, it didn't, Cal. Whoever it was covered up the track.
Neither of them. Rangers have done it.
What makes you think that, Cal?
Well, who else could have done it?
Well, most anybody could have done it, Cal. Might have been me, or the sheriff, or even you.
No, me?
Sure.
No. It wasn't me. I didn't do it.
Do what, Cal?
Kill Fred.
Cal wanted to know who might have done the killing. I said maybe it was him. Well, say, maybe it was.
No, sir. No. Say, I got to get back to the station and send out another mail pouch.
Sending out another rider?
Isn't that the rider? I've got to take it myself.
When are you leaving?
About an hour.
Oh, poor Cal. Sure has a hard time with his talk.
Yes, sir. Sheriff, while you was inside, I had an idea. And that's why I waited for you to come out.
Yes? Well, what's your idea, Colonel?
Well, I was thinking if you want to find out if those two strangers is guilty, why don't you let them out of jail and keep an eye on them? See where they go and what they do.
But they might try to get away.
Then you'll know they're guilty. You can go after them.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
You won't find out anything keeping them in jail. Turn them loose, and if they're guilty, you ought to soon find out.
What do you think of this whole business? You got any ideas?
Yes, why didn't it look like we're going to have to tell the sheriff who we are?
Yeah, he can't get the murderer checked in here and here. See, by the way, who is this colonel?
Well, from what I can gather, came to Midville a few weeks ago. He's been staying at the sheriff's ranch. He told the sheriff he was aiming to buy land for a ranch of his own.
You think him and the sheriff the idea of horses together?
Don't know, Eddie.
You ain't. What about the user that takes care of the horses for the rider?
You mean the chap that stutters?
Yeah, poor fellow. He's got a hard time seeing what he thinks.
Yeah, well, why would he want to kill one of his own riders and rob the mail?
Well, that's what I'm asking you.
Well, there's plenty of questions to be answered in this case, but first, we've got to get out of here.
Here comes somebody, no?
All right, if it's the sheriff, I'm going to tell him who we are.
Howdy, boys.
Glad you came in, Sheriff. Wanted to have a little talk with you.
And plenty of time for talking. I've been thinking things over.
Yeah?
Of course. There's strangers in these parts, and we've got to be careful. Especially when there's been a murder.
That's all right, Sheriff. We understand.
Well, what I'm leading to is this. If you promise to stay around town a few days, I'll let you out of this jail.
Well, that's mighty decent of you, Sheriff. You'll stay around as long as you say.
Good. You'll find a good boarding house across from the cafe.
Thanks, Sheriff. We'll be around if you need us.
Well, Colonel?
Yes, mister, it's the rich bankers in the East that keep this country poor.
Rider leaves in an hour.
Ah, you're right, Colonel. Okay, gotta be moving.
Well, good day, sir. I'm glad to talk to you.
Lightning, why do you think the sheriff changed his mind? He let the thought to you, Lightning.
Well, that's what we're aiming to find out, Reddy. We're being watched. You can bet on that.
Well, Annie, you got to be careful what you do.
Hey, that
Jasper seems to be in an awful hurry.
No, I saw him come out there to cafe across the street.
Yeah, and here comes our friend, the Colonel, too.
Well, good day to you, gentlemen.
Howdy, Colonel.
Hello there.
I just heard the sheriff let you out of jail.
Yeah.
He hasn't got any evidence against you. There's no reason to keep you in jail.
That's right.
Boys, I got a little business to talk over with you all.
That's so. What kind of business, son?
Well, you all interested in making some money?
Yeah. What's on your mind, son?
You know that bridge over Midville Creek when you go out the West Trail.
Yeah, that's the trail we come in on.
Yeah, that's right. Well, I'll meet you out there in about half an hour, and I can assure you all that what I have in mind will be worth your while.
I see. You figure it's better to talk out there, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Under the present circumstances, I think that'd be better, sir. Well?
All right, Colonel, we'll be there.
Good. I'll expect you.
Well, what do you know about that?
Things are beginning to clear up, Whitey.
Well, what do you mean?
There goes Cal taking out the mail pouch.
Yeah, I know, but you ain't told me what to think.
Right now, we're getting our horses. Come on, Whitey.
I'll shoot over his head.
Put up your hands, mister. We've got you covered.
Don't.
All right, now hand over that mailbag.
Here you are.
Take his rifle.
I got it.
Now go on before we change our minds and throw you.
Do it.
Yeah, he's just a little bit.
Well, come on, let's get up to the cabin.
You think the sheriff and the next man are following you? Yeah, more than likely. Yeah, but I thought we were going to meet the colonel near the bridge. Why do you think the plan to pin the blame on us? You mean that we walked into a trap? Well, we would have if we stayed back there at the bridge. Don't put your hands down, Cal. What happened to you?
The mail house. The gunners. Who got it? The two bandits. Who got it? You're right, Jim. They're close to the posse.
Which way's them bandits go, Cal?
No.
North?
Uh-huh.
Up the north. Let's go from there.
Get up. Holy smoke! Hey, get away from the posse! No,
what do you know about that?
The mail pouch, Cal.
No, sir.
Ah, they're the guilty ones, all right.
Yeah, come on, let's get them.
Come on, boys. Yeah, we were lucky to pick up the trail.
You're heading for that chest down in the gorge.
Well, we'll circle a bit and come down on them from the north. Let's go under. When he comes and pays us off for this job, we're going to take all the cash he's got on him, and then we're clearing out of here.
I wonder if there's any cash in his mailbag.
Open it up.
Just a bunch of letters.
But we got to play safe, Jordy.
What do you mean?
I don't trust that Colonel Nohow. He might get the idea of double-crossing us and cutting the law on our tail. We'll get his cash and drill him.
Good day, gentlemen.
What? It's him.
I've got you both of it. Now, don't move or I'll let you have it.
So, what's the idea, Colonel?
I left my horse down in the trees below the cabin. I just wanted to hear what you had to say. So, you were planning to take my cash and drill me, hmm? Too bad I spoiled your plan.
Well, wait a minute. No, I don't see, Colonel. We were just kidding.
Kidding, eh? Well, gentlemen, you'd better say your prayers.
buddy.
You walk. Get in the cabin.
Yeah. Keep behind these trees and move up on them.
Wait, somebody's coming.
It's the colonel.
Reach for the sky, Colonel.
Where'd you come?
Never mind that. Reach for the sky and be quick about it.
No, no, you don't.
No. Get his gun. Oh. I just blasted his arm.
You're like an agent.
Where's his pocket?
Oh, I do that.
Oh, my arm. Don't touch me.
Oh, well, I got to see what you got there. Oh. Here. They have some letters.
Let me have them.
Oh, here they are.
Keep your gun on that, Jasper.
Oh, I got them. You can hear me. Here comes the sheriff and the posse.
Yeah, and this time we won't be running away from them.
Put up your hands.
Both of
you. We took your
cover. All right, Sheriff. Drop your gun.
Yeah.
Thought you could get away, eh?
Arrest those men, Sheriff.
Colonel Banks. What are you doing here?
I followed these men and their two partners up here.
Two partners?
Yes. I got them in the cabin. And then these two come up. They shot my gun away.
You two varmints are under arrest.
Hold on, Jeff. You got the wrong men. The man who planned these holdups to the express riders is the colonel himself.
What are you talking about?
That's a lie. Arrest them, Jeff.
Jeff, we just took these letters from the colonel's pocket. Two of them are messages from the War Department in Washington, addressed to Fort Edwards and Fort Davis.
But what's that got to do with the case?
The colonel's a spy.
A spy? What are you talking about?
He worked on your friendship and hospitality to cover up his plans. With the trouble brewing between the North and the South, these messages are valuable information to the South.
But I still don't see where you come in.
When me and my partner come along, the colonel got you to let us out of jail so we'd get blamed for the holdups and murder. Now, since this is a government crime, Colonel Banks, you're under arrest.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm the sheriff here. If there's any arrest, then I'll do it. Who do you think you are, anyway?
My sheriff, this is the United States Morrison, Lightning Yim.
What got you?
Gone! Too bad, why didn't you say what you mean to
remember that? Our bet about giving our real name?
Yeah.
Well, you owe me a nice big steak dinner.
You mean me?
And so ends another thrilling chapter in the lives of United States Marshal Lightning Jim Whipple and his deputy, Whitey Larson.